A substance currently consists of 100 grams and it decays at a continuous rate of 7% per year. Determine the number of years it will take for the amount of the substance to decrease to 40 grams of its current amount. To get a ballpark figure, recall the rule of 70. The rule of 70 can be used to quickly approximate the half-life. Just take 70 and divide by the decay rate as a percentage. In this case, the decay rate as a percentage is 7%. So we take 70 and divide by 7, and that comes out to be 10. So the half-life is approximately 10 years. Initially, there were 100 grams of the substance. The half-life tells us that after 10 years, there will be approximately 50 grams remaining. After another 10 years, there will be half of 50, or 25 grams remaining. We're trying to determine how long it will take for 40 grams to be remaining. Well, 40 is between 25 and 50, so that tells us that our answer is somewhere between 10 and 20. So we can eliminate D and E. Those answers are unreasonable. Our answer must be A, B, or C. To determine the number of years more precisely, we'll want to set up and solve an equation. We're given that the amount decays at a continuous rate of 7% per year. That indicates that a natural exponential model is most appropriate. The exponential decay model is A of t is equal to A sub 0 times e to the kt, where A sub 0 is the initial amount and k is the opposite of the continuous decay rate. In this case, the initial amount is 100 grams, so A sub 0 is equal to 100. And the continuous decay rate is 7% per year, so k is equal to negative 0.07. Notice that we express k as a decimal, and k is negative because we're working with decay. So we substitute these values into the natural exponential function, and we get A of t is equal to 100 times e raised to the negative 0.07 t. We want to determine the number of years it will take for the amount of the substance to decrease to 40 grams. So we'll substitute 40 for A of t and then solve for t. To solve this equation, first of all, divide both sides by 100. We get 0.4 is equal to e to the negative 0.07 t. T is in the exponent of e, so we'll want to take the natural logarithm of both sides to undo the exponentiation. The result is the natural logarithm of 0.4 is equal to negative 0.07 t. The final step is to divide both sides by negative 0.07. We find that t is equal to the natural logarithm of 0.4 divided by negative 0.07. We can use our calculator to approximate this expression. Find the natural logarithm of 0.4 divided by negative 0.07. And it comes out to be 13.1. So t is equal to 13.1 years, which is between 10 and 20 years, like we anticipated. The correct answer is A. An alternative way to solve the equation is by graphing. We could go to y equals, and for y1, enter the left-hand side of the equation, which is 40. For y2, enter the right-hand side of the equation, which is 100 times e raised to the negative 0.07. And then instead of using t, we use x. Next, set up a good viewing window. We go to the window, and we've already anticipated that our answer is between 10 and 20 years. So we'll enter 10 for x minimum, 20 for x maximum. A scale of 1 is appropriate. And for y min and y max, we're trying to determine when the amount of the substance decreases to 40, and it originally started out at 100 grams. So for y minimum, we want to make sure that 40 is between y min and y maximum. I'm going to select 0 and 80, since 40 is halfway between those two values. And instead of using a y scale of 1, I'm going to use a y scale of 10. We then go to the graph. And we notice that the two graphs intersect. We want to find that point of intersection, so we go to calculate, which is second trace. Select intersect, which is number 5. Press enter to select the first curve, enter to select the second curve, and we were guessing that our answer was somewhere between 10 and 20, so I'll guess 15. And it locates the intersection where x is equal to 13.1 rounded to one decimal place. So either method gives us 13.1 years.